Hello, I'm David Tucker, and this is AWS This Week. Now, the cloud keeps marching on, and I have four, yes, four AWS announcements that you need to know about. We have a totally new way to define access to Lambda functions with attribute-based access control, the launch of extensions for AWS AppConfig, and the general availability of AWS Glue Streaming ETL auto-scaling. That's a mouthful. I've got also one extra announcement for all of you TypeScript developers, but you'll have to be patient for that one. To the news! First up, the way that you define permissions for Lambda might be forever changed. As of this week, you can now leverage attribute-based access control, or ABAC, for your Lambda functions. Now, if you're new to ABAC, this is the capability for using metadata, like tags, on an AWS resource to define permissions. This has the potential to save you a ton of time, because you can now do things like give a service team permission to invoke, delete, or update a Lambda function based off of a specific tag that you define. In this manner, you can make sure that any new service that the service team needs to work with includes that tag on creation. This means more IAM policies will get to remain unchanged, and you won't have to keep filing tickets to have Steve and Sharon from security keep adding new ARNs to the policy. Now, as a note, if you have a Steve and Sharon on your security team, let me know in the comments section. I'm sure we can find a prize for that happy bit of coincidence. Now, this functionality is available for you to try out today. Now, before we leave Lambda, I want to give you the mini announcement I teased earlier. If you are a TypeScript developer, the Lambda Powertools for TypeScript library is now generally available. Grab the link from the description to check this one out. Next up, many development teams have embraced feature flags as an essential element of modern application development. And AWS announced AppConfig as a feature of Systems Manager all the way back in 2019. And this service gives you the ability to define and consume runtime configuration for your applications running on AWS. This week, AWS took it to the next level with AppConfig extensions. This capability of AppConfig enables you to create event-driven applications when either creating or deploying an application configuration. It pulls in service integration with AWS services like SNS, EventBridge, and SQS. It even gives you the ability to leverage Lambda to create custom AppConfig extensions to automate pretty much anything you can think of. Now, another interesting feature of this is that it also includes support for Jira. Now, I realize that bashing Jira is the favorite pastime of developers, but it is still the most popular tool of its kind, so it's pretty cool to see AWS launch this capability with this support. Now, you have the ability to create or update a Jira issue based off of the action in your AppConfig configuration deployment. Now, this capability is available in all regions, and guess what? It is free, so check it out today. Finally, if you are leveraging Glue for your streaming data ETL, the auto-scaling capability is now generally available. With this capability, you no longer need to manually manage the resources that you were providing for Glue in your data pipeline. And hey, I'll gladly take some of the manual tasks off of my plate and give them to AWS. This sounds like a win-win. And with it being generally available, you can feel free to integrate this into your production streaming data pipelines. Well, that's it for this week, but you know how it works. We'll be back next week with the never-ending list of AWS updates that you need to know about here on AWS This Week. Now, if you want to stay always up to date on the AWS news that matters, be sure to hit that subscribe button and keep being awesome, Cloud Gurus.